Not only are there more ticks, but experts say they're young right now, so they live in clusters on leaves and tall grasses, so it's not uncommon to find more than one on you or your dog, and your risk of disease goes up in just a matter of hours.
There are 20 types of ticks in Minnesota, but the deer tick is most concerning. It spreads Lyme disease after contracting it from host animals like rodents. Your risk of getting it increases if a tick is attached to you for more than a day. And according to pest controllers, how it latches on is fascinating.
They have little hooks. Their front four hands have little hooks. They look just like hooks. And they just hang them out over the path. And as we drag by, those hooks connect onto animals, us, whatever it is, and that's how they hitch a ride.
Ticks live in shady, overgrown areas and will die if exposed to sunlight and short grass.
A tick really can't survive in a manicured lawn. They'll desiccate. It's essentially like putting a human in the Mojave Desert, right?
The U of M School of Public Health says a rise in ticks could also mean there was a large acorn crop, which can lead to more rodents that the ticks feed on. Out west at Baker Park Campground, Ken Schilling and his family say they do daily checks for deer ticks. They're easier to spot because of their reddish-brown body.
Yeah, makes you feel crawly all over, yep.
If you find the parasite on your body, use a tweezer to pull it out instead of rubbing alcohol or a match so it doesn't get stressed out.
A lot of that stuff can actually cause the tick to regurgitate into your body, and that could actually make it worse to pass some of those pathogens to you.
Matt recommends tick repellent for your clothes and 2 insecticide treatments a year to prevent the pest in your yard, while Ken says he'll brave the bug, especially this holiday weekend.
No, I'm not worried about it, not to slow me down at all on camping and enjoying the day.
Tick season does last through July. It does peak again, though, in October. At Baker Park Campground, Jennifer Hoff, Care 11 News.